Pinpoint Doppler 12 has been tracking the earthquake's effects.
Chief Meteorologist Tony Petracca joins us with more on the tremor. Tony.
Well, actually, it's fairly common in New England as far as earthquakes in the northeastern United States. We actually average 40 to 50 per year. Now, most of the time, they're very, very weak. Every now and then, one will create a bit of a fuss, like the one up in Hollis, Maine, the epicenter located just outside of Portland, Maine. Now, the mechanism that creates quakes here in New England, completely different than out in California, where you have places like the San Andreas Fault, where the Earth's crust acts almost like a jigsaw puzzle, where plates kind of rub together. Different here in New England, but take a look. Now, we measure quakes on the Richter scale. This magnitude was 4.0, but we also measure how deep below the Earth's surface the quake was located. And this was considered a shallow quake, located about 4 miles below ground. And how deep or shallow the quake is will determine how far out the tremors are felt. And in this case, it was felt for many, many miles away from the Portland, Maine area, as far south as Long Island, New York. And to give you an idea, the activity in New England and the northeastern United States, every red dot represents some seismic activity since 1975. And you see, there are a lot of red dots, so it is fairly common in New England. Most of the time, though, the quakes tend to be very, very weak. We'll take a closer look at the forecast, the 7-day outlook. Mother Nature's been pretty busy. All that data coming up in a few minutes.